The Team Lally Show was previously recorded.
It's time to enter the world of real estate in Oahu with Hawaii's only true real estate radio show, the Team Lally Real Estate Show. Grab a pen and get ready to take notes. For the next full hour, Hawaii's premier real estate leader, Adrienne Lally, and Attilio Leonardi will bring you the latest in real estate news and real-world strategies on how they can guarantee to sell your home at a price and deadline you agree to, or they'll buy it. Now, here are your hosts, Adrienne and Attilio.
Welcome to the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the Guaranteed Sold program, or we'll buy it. If you have any questions, just give us a call at 799-9596 or on the web at teamlally.com.
Hey, everybody. This is Attilio, and this is the art part of the show, Attilio's Random Thoughts. This week, what I want to talk to you about is empathy. So I'm going to share with you some highlights on a video. It's a super popular video. It's got over 16 million views regarding empathy. The title of it is Brené Brown on Empathy. You can check it out on YouTube. Should come up right away. And she asked the question, and what's neat about the video, it's only about 3 or 4 minutes, is that I guess these people that do those kind of like animated shorts took her narration or her audio and then put it to this animation to give you some visuals with some bears and some a deer and a fox and everything. So it was pretty neat. And you can, it's probably a good thing to also watch with your kids because it would probably grab their attention with the animation.
Good for cartoon animation. All audiences.
So what is empathy and why is it different than sympathy? Here's the definition of empathy. Empathy creates, or one of the attributes of empathy, not necessarily the definition, but empathy creates connection. Mm-hmm. Adrian, what do you think sympathy does?
Sympathy is just more like...
Wait, I'm giving you the hint here.
Oh,
empathy
not connection.
Creates connection.
Not connection.
Yeah.
Unconnection. So, no connection.
And as Dr. Brené Brown says, it drives disconnection. So she also quotes a nursing scholar. I don't know what a nursing scholar is. It's a scholar who's a nurse. Mm-hmm. Anyway, Teresa Weisman, she studied the diverse professions where empathy is necessary. So think about professions where empathy is necessary.
In the medical industry.
Medical industry.
Doctors,
yep.
Need to have empathy.
Psychologists, therapists, things like that. Maybe even if you're a first responder.
Teachers. Yes, for sure. The teachers.
Okay. So she came up with this, Teresa Weisman, four qualities of empathy. Number one, perspective taking. The ability to be able to take another person's perspective, recognizing their truth. Because something can be completely true to someone, and for you, you're like, that don't make no sense to me. But then you're not being empathetic if that's your perspective, if you're focused only on your perspective and not the others. So number one, perspective taking. Number two, staying out of judgment. And she says, you know, it's not that easy when most of us enjoy it as much as we do. Ha ha. People laughed, right? We enjoy judging. We do it all the time. Number three, recognizing emotions in other people. Sometimes if you have this, who are people that don't recognize emotions in others?
Those would be people that are not empathetic.
Psychopaths.
Yes, the psychopaths.
So serial killers, stuff like that. Okay? Not good at recognizing emotions in other people because they have a hard time recognizing it in themselves. And then number four, communicating that you understand their emotions.
I would also say, I know this is not in your notes, but I think people that have autism also have issues with recognizing appropriate emotions and so forth. It doesn't necessarily mean that they're psychopaths.
Yeah, so what does a psychopath have in common with somebody with autism? Does that part of their connection in their brain has a hard time understanding or recognizing emotions or understanding those cues from others? So empathy, the definition, empathy is feeling with people. Feeling with people, I'll say that again. Do you know what is one of the things that we do for each other that demonstrates empathy and therefore builds trust? It's a simple thing. Do you know what it is?
Listening.
And listening. That's a good one. Mm-hmm. Attending funerals. Mm-hmm. And she says it's, and this wasn't in that video, but I've read it from her books, from other things. It's not necessarily anything you're doing or saying when you're at a funeral. It's just literally just being there.
Just being.
being there says a lot. Okay.
I think as real estate professionals that we need to be empathetic, yeah. and the ones that are more empathetic are going to create a better connection with their clients.
I think if you're empathetic, yes. no matter what you do, you're going to yes. be successful at it. Okay. Mm-hmm. And there's a sacred space or this deep hole that people fall into. And so you just imagine that your friend or somebody important to you or just another human being has fallen into this hole, figuratively and literally. And they're at the bottom of the hole and they're saying things like, I'm stuck. It's dark. I'm overwhelmed. And what you do and how empathy is defined with our actions is you climb down the hole and you say, hey, I know what it's like down here and you're not alone. Sympathy, you stay at the top of the hole and you talk from the top of the hole and you say things like, oh, wow, it's bad, huh? You want a sandwich? Total no connection, no empathy. And empathy is a choice. And right? Do you believe that? It's a choice, empathy? Yeah, I mean, for psychopaths and people with autism that don't have that connection, there is no choice because they don't know how to do it. But for 99.9% of us, empathy is a choice, and it's a vulnerable choice. And what do you think she means by that? It's a vulnerable choice.
Well, I would say because you're there with them, you need to be, talking about how, you know, you understand and that you're there and, you know, just listening and being empathetic. Yeah.
Well, this is how she describes true empathy. What you need to do is like whatever they're going through, then you're dredging it up within your mm-hmm. own mind and going back to that place. And then you're experiencing literally the same emotions that they're going through. So if someone needs to talk to you about divorce, then you start bringing up your own divorce. And mentally and emotionally, you're going there where they're at to meet them. And that's what truly creates empathy. So again, watch the video with your friends, family. You know, you should play it at your workplace. Brené Brown on empathy, 16 million views on YouTube. And it's a really good watch.
So speaking of someone who is very empathetic mm-hmm. with his clients and his customers, we've got Bradley Mariama of Allstate Insurance.
Hey, Bradley.
Good afternoon. How's everybody doing?
Good. What you got for us this week?
Okay. So recently I've been seeing a lot of purchases from parents and children living in their condos or homes.
Yeah.
And the comments, but, you know, a lot of homeowners don't realize that it does make a difference. But, you know, it's a technicality, but the proper way to insure these properties is for mom and dad to get a landlord's or a rental policy. Because even if son or daughter is not paying rent, the proper way to do it is not a homeowner's policy, but the proper way to do it would be a tenant-occupied homeowner's or condo policy, and many people don't realize that.
Mm-hmm.
The reason why it's also important is if things are stolen from your car or from your unit, that personal contents coverage would not extend to the children. So they would need a renter's policy on top of the tenant-occupied policy. And a lot of people don't realize that there is a technicality on this property or this type of
So Bradley, at what age should you add this renter's policy for the children? So like when they turn 18? Yeah. Is that the typical time to go ahead and make that little adjustment?
Good question. So it would usually be after they're not considered a dependent. So 26 of age or younger, or if they're not considered a dependent or occupant of the home.
Okay.
So in these particular situations I'm talking about, son and daughter lives in a property. Mom and dad has their own property, so they're not living in mom or dad's actual household. Mom and dad lives in Eva Beach, and son and daughter is now living in Waikele. But mom and dad is the title owners of the property.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, this is really confusing, but, you know, it happened 3 times in a week, so it was something that I really wanted to bring up.
So I would say that if you think that you might be in this situation, just give Bradley a call, and he's going to be able to advise you as far as how to be properly insured. and not be underinsured. Correct. And caught with not being able to recover your stolen or damaged.
Well, it's kind of like when the property tide goes out, yeah. You know who's not wearing board shorts.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
That would be the situation. Yeah. Then you're like, dang, I wish I should have had my board shorts on. I should have had the proper insurance for my shorts that got taken out of my mm-hmm. car that was owned by my kids.
So.
Well, and you know, the reason why it came up was the bank was trying to find their own insurance for the client. The client reached out to me because the realtor said, well, you should really get a second opinion. And then when the whole scenario came out, they were asking, so if my son, if there was a fire and all my son's guitars and computers got damaged, would there be coverage?
Yeah.
And that's when we started to explore, you know what, the quote you got is actually would not suffice your situation. They said, so how would we cover it? And that's when I said, well, the proper way was he would get a renter's insurance, you would get a tenant occupied policy. And then this way there would be no void, there would be no surprises if there was a bad fire or a theft in the condo or in his car.
Yeah.
That's why the scenario came up.
You know, Bradley, if I worked at your company and the parent called me up, I'd be like, is the guitar and all that music equipment covered, you know, in case something happens to it? The first question I would ask is, are they good? Do they have talent? Because if they're terrible, don't get the insurance, because it actually might be doing you a favor if it breaks or gets stolen. But if they're talented, then get the insurance. That's called the talent rider. No, I'm just kidding. I don't make insurance policies. We may have all kind of wacky stuff from
That's
me.
Right.
But anyway.
Well, thank you, Bradley. Excellent information, as always.
Yes.
Appreciate it.
Alrighty.
Okay, so you can get a hold of Bradley and his team at 591-8016. You can also check them out on our website, teamlally.com, under the resource tab on Experts We Trust.
Next up, we got, he's the karate kid who studied under the Mr. Miyagi of home inspections, specters, and now is the Mr. Miyagi of home inspections. We have Kenji from Pillar to the Post. Kenji, are you there?
Yes, I am. How are you guys today?
Yeah, we're doing great. And I can just imagine you waiting for your clients to show up at the home inspection to go over their summary. And you're like in that crane position with your arms up and you're standing on a fence post ready to go over.
Meditating very hard.
Ready to go over the home inspection report.
What's your tip this week?
Yeah, what you got for us this week?
This week, a lot of the homes, they're pretty... You know, they all have the same issues, so running into the normal double tapping where we take two electrical wires, throw it into one breaker, that's pretty normal across the state. And then little simple leaky valves here and there, nothing big or extraordinary that was like a big red flag,
mm-hmm.
but things that homeowners could do ahead of time if they kind of look around their house and see what can be done. Ground fault circuit interrupters, you know, that just needs to be installed in near the kitchen and bathrooms.
Yeah.
So a lot of my home inspections, they're all pretty much like, all right, you just have to do this little bit of thing for safety concerns, take care of the small little water leak to prevent further damages. So it's real kind of generalized for all homes, just have homeowners look out for these items, have them take care of them.
Yeah.
So it doesn't come up in their home inspection report. So, yeah, nothing too specific, but it's just a common trait that comes across home inspections.
You know, I would say that here's our recommendation, even with the market, how hot it is. Two things I'd recommend. Fill out the seller's disclosure, because that kind of jogs your memory. And it's got, I don't know, 90-plus questions on your home.
Mm-hmm.
Ask you things you're not thinking about. And then maybe even bringing Kenji to do a pre-inspection.
So you have a checklist.
Yeah.
And then and there's no surprises during the escrow period and room for renegotiation.
It's like, you know,
yeah.
It's like if you got this super cool stereo equipment, but you had the owner's manual to go with it. That's what the home inspection is, the pre-inspection for a home.
Okay.
Well, thanks, Kenji. Uh-huh.
Thank you, Kenji.
You're welcome.
So you can get a hold of Kenji and his team at 492-1675. He's with Pillar to Post. Again, you can go to teamlally.com. He's under our resource tab with the Experts We Trust.
All right. Next up, we got the karate kid who studied under Mr. Miyagi for financial planning. Yeah, I'm never going to get tired of that analogy. Kyle with Impact Wealth. Impact
Hello.
Wealth Solutions. What you got for us this week?
Well, you said that. I was thinking Cobra Kai.
Yeah.
Hello, everyone. So, thank you so much, Adrian Attilio. I've been getting a lot of referrals from realtors now that are working with clients that are doing 1031 exchanges, and at the last minute, they're getting that 45-day window to identify property, and then because of you guys, they realize they need to have a backup plan, that plan B.
Yeah.
So the Delaware Statutory Trust is a great plan B to take care of, have a backup plan in case the options 1 and 2 don't go through. And it's also a great way to take care of any boots. So if you do go with one of your other options, if there's any leftover equity that you need to park somewhere and buy real estate so you can defer the taxes, then DST minimum investment is $100,000.
I would say that it's also a good plan A. And I am getting ready to execute on my second DST with you guys, and I'm super excited about it. So have them run the numbers, and they will help to decide. Yeah. They'll help you to decide, is this DST a good plan A?
Mm-hmm. So
especially in the market.
Go ahead.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, a market right now where inventory is tight. A lot of people we find are sitting on their investment properties because they don't think they can find a replacement. So it's a great plan A. So you can sell that property and pick up something that you don't have to manage, and you get a check in your bank account every single month.
Yeah, and for those, there's a lot of people that maybe they got that one investment, two investment properties, they haven't sold them yet, and they don't even know a 1031 exchange. And I'm looking at this handy flyer that you gave to us. Day one, sell the property. By day 45, they need to identify the replacement property. And by day 180, they need to acquire the replacement property.
And with the replacement properties, they can have, there's three, I believe, that can be identified in case the first or second one doesn't work out.
Yeah, a couple rules.
Mm-hmm.
They can identify three or more. They just have to, whatever is on that list by day 45 has to be closed within 180. And that's the scary part, is that time frame is so tight.
Okay. All right.
Well, always great information. And thanks for calling in, Kyle.
Yeah.
All right. Thanks. Have a great day.
Thank you.
All right. So if any of our listeners want to learn more about the DST and when their next webinar is, go to teamlally.com/DST. And lots of info there and an opportunity to sign up for
a consult. We got webinars, consultations, everything you need to know about a DST is there if you just want to read it real quick. Speaking of people that are informative and are in the know, we have Mr. Maui. Maui. That's my impersonation of Israel Kamakabiba Ole singing the song Maui as an intro for Randy from Maui.
Aloha.
Aloha.
Welcome back.
Thank you. Nice to be back.
Yeah. So what's going on Maui?
What do you want to know? Besides the floods, we're good. Thank you so much.
Yeah. So how about, is Maui open? Because
Maui is definitely open. And we've been having crowds here since a lot of the tourists have come back since November when the hotels, most of the resorts opened up, the condo hotels are opened up. So we've been full force. Activities are happening, and there's traffic on the road.
I feel like Maui was like leading the way.
Yeah.
I feel like Maui's been more open than Oahu or Big Island. Like you guys are kind of setting the paces for the rest of us.
Yeah. And that's very true,
And not to put you on the spot, because if you don't know, people can Google it, but what's the COVID rule for coming from another island and or from the mainland to Maui?
Well, I as far as I know, because things change a lot, they're still enforcing 3 days before arrival to have a negative COVID test to bypass the 10-day quarantine, and I'm not sure about inter-island. I'm not sure.
That's changing all the time,
I know. Yeah.
Just, make sure you're going to be there for more than 10 days. You're all taken care of.
There's plenty to do.
Yeah.
Why would you be here for less than 10 days?
Yeah. Right?
What's happening with inventory? Where are you seeing, is inventory tight with the single families and the condos? Is it different between the two?
Yeah, it's still very tight. Our single family home market has dropped drastically. down to about less than 250 homes for sale on the whole island.
Oh, wow.
And, yeah, some key markets like Kihei and Kahului, we're seeing homes, and West Maui, which are the key markets, actually. Those homes under a million are probably less than 10 or 5 in some of the areas right now. So very tight, but a lot of condos still on the market. So opportunities for condos.
What's your tip to your, if you are sitting down with a buyer to do a consultation right now to buy a home on Maui, what would be your top one or two or three things that you would tell this person as advice?
I would tell them to be very patient.
Yeah.
If they're trying to find a home, obviously to be patient, and there's always new inventory coming up, of course. But if they're going to get involved in a multiple offer situation, then of course they have to just try to put in their highest and their best, because sometimes you don't get a second chance.
Yeah. What if
you get pre-approved, of course.
And get pre-approved. Yeah. So I was going to say, what if you were Arnold and you were a realtor on Maui? Would you be saying stuff like, you need to get pre-approved. You have to be motivated. Get to the open house now.
I do that every day, but they don't listen to me.
You just been beat out because you did not get pre-approved.
Exactly.
So
my sentiments, exactly.
And I think, so here's what we're telling people on Oahu. We're looking in places like Mililani. Like, there's no, everything's in escrow.
Like, wow.
It's like one of those, what those movies, Gone in 60 Seconds?
Or less than 60 seconds.
Yeah, we're like on part 5, Gone in 60 Seconds.
We have coming soons that are like being offered on.
The remake is so bad that the actors, you don't even know who these actors are. They're like the B actors that are like the main actors because we're on this episode of Gone in 60 Seconds. Here's what we're telling people. If you're not super motivated, like drop and give me 20 pre-approvals right now, and you're not pre-approved, so pre-approved and super motivated, stay home already.
Yeah.
Stay in your rental with your crazy landlord that's driving you batty. Suck it up, Chuck. But you got to be pre-approved and you got to be motivated.
I'm ready to compete.
And ready to go.
Yeah, because there's just not enough inventory for everyone right now.
Yeah. Write the offer. I mean, you tell people, write the offer, see the property later.
I would say, too, that also it has to do, like, you got to have a real savvy realtor helping you. So, Randy's pretty savvy over there.
Yeah.
We're all hustling.
That's right.
We're all hustling, trying to find properties for the clients, and that means looking at canceled properties and, expired listings and calling past clients. You know, you just got to go behind the doors and see what you can find.
That's right.
I know. You start
turning over every rock.
You know how people start chumming the water? As soon as you see one pod in the driveway, everybody's like, hey,
knocking on the door.
You got one pod. You think you're selling? No, we just moving in.
Yeah. I mean, I'm already asking strangers that I need just at random. You got a house to sell?
Yeah. By any chance,
while I'm waiting in line at the grocery store.
Hey, how's the sale on papayas? By the way, do you have a house for sale? You got to do whatever it takes. Whatever it takes. And Randy's hungry.
Randy's hungry to
help people. So, all right. Yeah. Thank you.
Thanks, Randy.
Thanks you for the Maui
My
update.
Pleasure.
Okay.
Anytime. Thank you so much. Have a great one.
You too.
All right. So you can call Randy at 276-6473 for any of your Maui needs.
All right. We're going to take a break?
We are.
All right. So we're going to take a break. Stay with us. We're going to have Richard Weylman of Weylman Consulting. We're going to be talking to him about how to fill your pipeline of business and how to turn your clients into advocates.
That's
so
right.
Stay with us.
This is Scotty B from News Radio 830 KHVH.
Buying a home is not something we do a ton of times in our lives, usually. And maybe you have this idea, this dream home that you've planned for. When it comes time to make that move, you don't want anything messing it up. And that was the situation where Rebecca Garcia found herself, and that's why she contacted Team Lally. She was moving back to the mainland, needed to sell a longtime investment rental property to purchase her dream home. Team Lally ignited their incredible marketing machine, and within a month, sold Rebecca's Y&I home. Her dream home is now her reality. Smooth sailing from here on, thanks to Adrian Lally and Attilio Leonardi and Team Lally Real Estate Group of Keller Williams Honolulu. So confident are they in their marketing strategy, they guarantee to sell your home at a price and deadline that you've agreed to in advance, or they're going to buy it. And just a few more reasons to give my friends Adrian and Attilio a call today. You can do that at 799-9596. 799-9596. Online, teamlally.com, teamlally.com.
Hey, it's Sean Hannity here, and I know the business climate has changed dramatically, but if you need to sell your home, don't believe the myth that homes aren't selling. Joining me now is a true expert at selling homes, Adrian Lally and Attilio Leonardi of Team Lally Real Estate Group of Keller Williams, Honolulu. So what's your advice on selling a home right now?
Sean, our real estate team has always been on the cutting edge with technology. We're using FaceTime for showing homes with buyers and keeping our buyers and sellers safe with a virtual showing at any time and any place. We've sold hundreds of homes this way.
So what does that mean for sellers?
Sean, ignore the fake news. This is an incredible opportunity for sellers. Supply has plummeted. Demand has skyrocketed. People still have to move. We have thousands of motivated buyers ready to buy. We eliminate the tire kickers, conduct the virtual showing safely, quickly, and conveniently to sell their homes.
All right, thanks so much. Look, talk to the agent that I trust for the best advice. Call Team Lally now at 799-9596. Online at 808GuaranteedSale.com.
Hi, I'm Barbara Corcoran. I hope every family will stay healthy and safe during these uncertain times. Our real estate market is experiencing many challenges every day. If you're planning to move or sell your home now, be sure to get the most current information from the best agent in your marketplace. In Honolulu, you should call Adrian Lally and Attilio Leonardi. You'll need an agent who is trusted in your community and understands your needs. Go online or call, and please stay safe.
The Team Lally Real Estate Show continues.
Give it to me, I'm worth it. Baby, I'm worth it. Welcome back, and thanks for listening to the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the Guaranteed Sold program, or we'll buy it. I'm Adrian.
And I'm Attilio.
And if you have any questions, just give us a call at 799-9596 or check us out online at teamlally.com.
As promised prior to the break, we want to bring or welcome aboard. It's like, what are we on? The love boat here?
Yes.
I'm Captain Stubing. So anyway, Richard Weylman of Weylman Consulting. And the two big questions we want to talk about is how to fill our pipelines with more business and how to turn our clients into to advocates. Adrian, some highlights on Richard? Just a few.
Well, I mean, there's so many. I don't even know how to pick. He's an amazing man. He, you know, comes from being an orphan at age 6, and he's lived in over 19 different foster homes and attended 11 different schools. So, I mean, coming from that, he has definitely had created some remarkable business success, including a general sales manager of an award-winning Rolls Royce dealership to heading sales and marketing for the Robb Report from its inception until its record liquidity event. So today, he serves as chairman of Weylman Consulting Group, and he's an author of 3 international bestsellers, the latest of which, The Power of Why.
So we want to welcome Richard Weylman. Richard, are you there?
Hey, yes, I am here, and it's so good to hear both of your voices today. Aloha.
Yeah, aloha. And
I want to say welcome back.
Yeah, welcome
back. I think
back.
You are like a repeat guest of ours.
Yeah.
And it's you always
Adrian.
Bring value.
Yeah.
So.
Well, I love to talk to you and Attilio. It's wonderful. Thank you, Adrian.
Well, you know, I always listen to other radio shows so I can like, oh, how do we make our show just like that? And you know what they do? They just hit them with the question right off the bat. So what would be, you know, we see the validity, the credibility that you have. Been doing this for a long time. Let's start off with how, you know, with this pandemic, these pivoting, these changes in our world, how do we fill our business, our pipeline of business with more clients, more sales, all of that good stuff?
Okay. We can look at it from many different perspectives, but the most important perspective is the consumers.
Mm-hmm.
Because in all reality, that's, with all due respect, the only one that matters.
Yeah.
So you have to ask yourself what's really happened. We'll just say in America. I'm sure we got broadcast worldwide here. My clients in India are experiencing nearly the same shift in consumer behavior as an example. Here's what's happening. Because of this pandemic, and every one of your listeners would likely agree, because of this pandemic, the networks, the people they know, the friends, the family, the people that they work with, perhaps people in the club they belong to or where their children go to school, these networks have really become the glue, if you will, that have helped people keep their sanity These are the people they reach out to for Zoom meetings or on FaceTime, and they're connected to them. So what we've uncovered, to fill your pipe, is anyone in sales, marketing, regardless of what you sell, but certainly in real estate, you should be laser-focused on identifying the networks that your best customers, I'll use that phrase today, your best customers are in. Just to give you an illustrative example, if you have customers right now, or clients, people that have purchased a home from you, let's use that example. Terrific. What I've uncovered through my discussions with most realtors, they don't ask many networking questions like, what club do you belong to? Where do your children go to school? What is the reading group to which you belong? Do you belong to a surf club? What are you involved in? They really don't go that next step to really uncover, I often call them hidden markets or hidden opportunities.
Yeah.
Now, why is this important? Because the latest survey that we did of 350 affluent people, this is a stunning number, 87% of them said that they are currently keeping their sanity by being plugged into networks that are important to them, meaning friends, family, and other people, colleagues, with whom they have something, we'll say, in common, just for a number, for a nomenclature. But here's the bigger point. 71% of those people said that they rely on the people in their network to make recommendations about with whom they should be doing business.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Yeah, the famous question always posted in social media, who would you recommend for a hitman? I got a neighbor that's driving me. No. We don't do hitman referral program, but you know what I mean. Fill in the blank with something else.
You know, one of my
nefarious.
One of my favorite connecting questions with clients is, what do you like to do for fun? You know, that always gets people to open up, and they will usually light up, right? Because if they're doing something that's fun, they enjoy it, and they're likely passionate about it.
Yeah, we had this one client. He was a professional olive stuffer, and he was part of a professional olive stuffing club, Facebook group, everything. And we connected with that. No, I'm just making that up. But, I mean, you get the point, right? Mm-hmm. They're all birds of a feather.
Here's the next point. You're exactly right. Birds of a feather flock together. So the follow-up point is, okay, Richard, I've identified my networks. I've got clients or customers that belong to this, belong to this, belong to this. Great. Yeah. Why don't you go on Facebook, to your point? Why don't you connect to their group? Most of them have one. Identify the associations or clubs to which they belong. Almost everybody's online today because of the pandemic. I mean, it's not like we're going over to the country club. And connect and follow those groups, and then do a posting of it from your client about it, the work that you've done on their behalf.
Mm-hmm.
Because people are now on, and we know this, they're online looking all the time at the groups they're involved in, the people they're following, the influences in their community. And if they see that someone in their, let's call it network, have made a recommendation or made a commentary about you as a provider, that inspires people. I just did a webinar this morning with a group in New Jersey, a research group. Here's what they found out. When somebody targets a specific group of people or networks, here's what happens. The people in that network, the prospects, have more confidence and curiosity to engage because they know you know who they are, they know what their issues are, and likely what type of, let's say in your case, home they would want to buy, meaning what neighborhood they could afford, because they're in the same socioeconomic group. So it's important. That's a first step. You've really got to focus today, because being all things to all people, you're just going to get crushed.
Yeah.
That's one suggestion I'd give you. I have a couple of others I think would be appropriate, but that's a place to start.
Well, I like that, what you just said. That is, I think it's the bane of everyone's existence and failure, is trying to be everything to everyone. We as realtors, we're super guilty of that.
Set a focus.
Oh, what do you do? I do property management. I do commercial residential. I help buyers. I help sellers.
I do timeshares.
I do timeshares. I manage my own transactions. And then I also help buy and sell used cars. So, I mean, we're doing everything.
Somebody says, what do you do?
Yeah.
Here's your answer. If I'm a realtor, here's what I'm going to say.
Yes.
Somebody says, what do you do? I'm in a commercial man and I did property management. No.
Yeah.
What I'm going to say is, I love what I do.
Yeah.
Because my clients say I help them find a home of their dreams.
Mm-hmm.
That's a nice one.
What does that say? What's the first thing somebody's going to ask? Wow. So how do you do that?
Exactly.
It evokes emotion.
I don't know about you, but I love it when they opt in.
You give them a, you can either give them a tickler statement or you can actually tickle them. But because of the social distancing.
I mean, I give you an example.
No tickling.
Look at Walmart.
Yeah,
Walmart,
tickler statement's better.
And Walmart's a classic example.
Yeah.
When Doug took over there, he's one of my CEO groups. When Doug took over there, they had for almost 14 years set low prices every day. I mean, that was, it was on every truck, every apron, every aisle, every sign. Low prices every day. I said, what's the first thing you're going to do, Doug? He said, the first thing I'm going to do is stop trying to convince people to come to Walmart.
Yeah.
But I'm going to tell them what they can accomplish. I said, like what? He said, well, let's start with save money, live better. Well, look at their numbers.
Yeah.
I mean, they've had record quarter after record quarter. Everything's up. Inventory turns are faster. More people are in the stores. Now, why? People are going there because they can what? Save money and live better.
With that one little tweet.
What do you do?
One little tweet.
Yeah, so what do you do? I sell commercial real estate? Well, terrific. I'll type that into my browser, and let's see if we can probably get 300 links in Honolulu.
Yeah.
Why don't we tell, what I do is I love what I do because my commercial real estate clients love the fact that I find them exactly the right space they're looking for and get them the lease that they deserve.
Yeah.
That's going to make me ask the next question. How do you do that? Or well, let me tell you what I'm looking for, or whatever the case might be.
Yeah. Well, you're creating, you're answering a question and then creating curiosity.
Bingo. And the truth is, the industry, and I'll talk to real estate if that's what you like, the real estate industry is in love with their credentials. They're in love with their history. I've got years of experience. I've sold millions of them. They're all in love with that.
Yeah.
But the consumer, they're in love with one idea. How do I get the home of my dream?
Mm-hmm.
Or how do I save money on my lease? That's what they're in love with, the experience. The realtor is in love with their experience, but what the client or the customer is in love with is the experience they're going to have if they hire you as their realtor or is their home with you.
It needs to be a client-centric focus.
Yeah.
In order to create, you know, to create the repeat business and that connection, those
referrals,
those advocates, right, that we talked about.
Boy, well said. And how do you turn them into advocates? May I speak to that for
of
just a
moment? Of course.
Yes.
Please.
Okay. I will tell you, I've gone to a lot of open houses in my lifetime, you know, because I've, well, as you well know, I've had that opportunity. All right.
Yeah.
What amazes me, you walk into an open house, and what does the realtor say? Hi, thank you for coming. Feel welcome to look around. And by the way, make sure you sign in.
Yes.
Sign in. Go ahead and sign in. So people walk up and they have a pen or whatever and they write down their name. Nothing else, just their name. Maybe their email, but unlikely. So then they wander around, eat the free cookies, drink a little punch, and they're out the door to the next open house.
Mm-hmm.
But you know what? I have never, how many times? Let's go with never. Have I ever had a follow-up from a realtor where I signed a book? Even if I put my email and my phone number in there.
Yeah.
I find that remarkable.
You haven't come to any of our open houses. That's why.
Right.
We're like a Venus flytrap.
Yes, I'm proud of you. I'm proud of you. That's why I do this show. So,
yeah.
But that said, instead of saying sign in here, why can't the realtor walk over to book? Oh, thank you so much for coming. We're delighted that you're here. Please write your name, your email address. So because even if you're not interested in this particular home, I'll keep you up to date on things that come up on the market, even if you're looking for a year from now.
Yeah.
So what do people say? Oh, I better put my email address up. Now, why would, within 48 hours, I mean, we're a research-based consulting firm. What we found out is if someone hears from the person they had initial contact with, so in your case, the realtor, at that open house, if they hear from them within 48 hours, they save their contact information for a future engagement or inquiry.
Yeah.
If they hear within 48 hours. If it's next week, it's like, who is that, do you think, honey? I don't remember. You can just delete that. I mean, these are little things, but this is how you feel about the virtual world.
Be timely with your follow-up.
Well, create that connection because they're... Yeah. You're just one of 10 realtors they saw today, because if they went to 10 open houses, right?
Right. Yeah. Well, I'll flip it over. Let's talk about trade shows and home shows. You know what the average time is after somebody fills out a lead card?
Mm-mm.
It takes 7 weeks for the company to get back to those people that were at that trade show or that home show. 7 yeah. weeks.
Holy
it's
cow.
Actually a little over 7 weeks before they hear from
wow.
these people.
What are they waiting for? A pandemic? Oh, wait, it's happening already. Apparently. It's happening already. So
the other thing is I would encourage every single realtor to have a digital business card.
Yeah.
Now, why? Well, it's very simple. You can hand them a business card. It probably gets over the visor before it gets on the floor, before it gets taken out of the car wash.
Yeah.
If people, here's my digital business card. Hold up your phone and boom, we'll just exchange. And what happens is they load your digital business card, but you also end up with their cell phone in your phone.
Yes. And then when you
That's
call
a good
them,
one.
Like,
when you call them, you're showing up on their phone.
That's right. They'll answer when you call them.
People today, what number is this? I don't know. They won't answer it. But if it shows up and it says, Adrian, oh, Adrian, hi. I wanted to thank you for coming to the open house. It was just wonderful to see you. I'm going to keep you up to date. I just want to double check your email address. And here's another thing. Don't ever say feel welcome. Don't say feel free to call me.
Yeah.
Say feel welcome to call me at any time. I am, remember this phrase, feel welcome to call me at any time. I am, or we are here for you.
I like that we part. By the way, you know, for I always, and exactly what you talk about, great minds think alike. I tell all our agents, forget about business cards.
Phones.
Get in their phone, and then your title. You right, you get your first and last name. This is what I put for my title. Your mom.
No.
I always get the answer. They always answer my call, especially on Mother's Day for some reason. Now, I put, actually, you know what I put on there? I put my realtor. Mm-hmm. I put my realtor because I want that scrolling across the top of their phone when they're debating on whether to call me or not. And you hit on another fact that we know in our industry is absolutely the data proves it. 70% to 80% of your income in the real estate business, I'm sure it could probably translate into all sales, comes from follow-up.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody's walking into an open house. I want to buy this house. Will you help me write an offer? No.
Yeah, they don't walk in and say, I need help with a sales contract. Would you be available?
Yeah.
It doesn't quite work that way. No, I got to say this, Adelia. It's unbelievable you mentioned Mother's Day.
Yeah.
Because I had a thought this morning when I was doing my miles thinking about your upcoming show.
Yeah.
And this is a suggestion I'd made to a group a couple of weeks ago in financial services. Mother's Day is coming. If I were a realtor, I would go through my entire database of everybody I've sold a house to or rented, whatever. Anybody that ever became a customer that I knew was a mom, and I'd sit down and I would record a 30-second video on my phone to say, I want to say Happy Mother's Day. I really hope you're enjoying your new home. We're just thinking of what you do today. We're really grateful for all that you do for your family and your community. If you ever need me, I'm here for you. Boom, and you send it to every single mom in your phone.
And
that's a good one. Make sure you also send it to your own mom.
What I do is then right at the end, I throw on a wig and sound like that stern auntie. And remember, call your mom. So
yeah, but those are the kinds of things that elevate the experience.
Yes,
and. And everybody's all confused with elevator. They think it's good service. Good service is just a basic fundamental today.
Mm-hmm.
What people want is an elevated experience. And what is that? That is consistent positive impressions of thoughtfulness that someone does on their behalf.
Mm-hmm.
So if I'm a realtor, every thoughtful expression I do on your behalf is my client or even my prospect. As an individual, maybe I talked to 3 months ago, and they said, I might buy next year. Great. Well, Mother's Day is coming. You got them on the phone. Just say, I was just thinking of you.
Yeah.
Just an extra touch.
Yeah, and guess what? That's a positive impression. Mm-hmm. And people don't want to be taken for granted.
Yeah.
No.
People don't want just good service. They don't want to be the count. They don't want to be closing. They don't want to be a buyer. They want to be an individual.
They want to be heard. We actually were on a call with a client just – she was expressing that she just, you know, she wanted to be heard and felt that we were, you know, listening and understand their needs.
Yeah.
So that's what people want. They just want to be heard.
They want connection. They don't want to be closed.
That's right.
Yeah.
Boy, that's so well said. That was brilliantly said. Thank you, both of you. That was good. They want a connection. They don't want to be closed. And that's exactly what people are looking for today.
I think they're starving for it, too, with all this home sheltering and social distancing.
Yeah.
You know, human beings, we know we're genetically wired to be connected with each other.
More so than any other time in our history. They're they're craving that right. connection.
Except for Crazy Charlie at the park. Stay away from him.
Richard, you're
a whole other topic.
So you're offering some webinars, some trainings. Can you share with our listeners a little bit about that and where could they go to have a connection with you and your consulting firm?
Oh, well, thank you. That's very kind of you to mention that. I do several a year where I do webinars where people, we call them town halls now because we got people from all different industries, et cetera, although I do them by specific industries occasionally upon request. But they can go to Richard, and I'll spell the last name, WEYLMAN.com.
Gotcha.
Richard at RichardWeylman.com. And just click on the blog. And you can enroll, and every week I send you a tip on this or an idea on that. It goes out every Tuesday, as you both know. Mm-hmm. And then when I do what we call public webinars, where I do these town halls, then you'll get an invitation. You can sign up. And, I mean, it's a wild and crazy time. These are usually, we schedule them for an hour, but I did one about a month ago, and it was 2 hours and 40 minutes. People just kept firing questions in the chat.
And I think,
and it's fun because they learn from each other too. Does that make sense?
You're having information flow in both directions, not just from you to them, but back amongst each other. And
I learn a lot.
Yeah,
truthfully, you know, somebody will say something, you're like, whoa. Like today, you said, you know, people want a connection, they don't want to be close. Thanks. 1-800. That'll be a tip.
Exactly.
So thank you.
And so for our endorsement of Richard, we've had you in training sessions with our groups, we brought you in on a mastermind group. Great information, good stuff. If you have an organization, whether you're in sales or not, you should bring him in, because this is what we always tell people. We always bring in outside people to speak to our team, because you can never be a prophet in your own village. I mean, people are like, you know, but then you bring in Richard and they're like, that totally makes sense. Because he's got the stranger effect and credibility and validity. So thank you, Richard, for being on the show. You're kind of you're like Michael Baldwin, you know, on like The Late Show. He's been on there like Saturday Night Live. You're like the repeating host, guest that's been on the show.
Because he always brings so much value. That's why.
Mm-hmm.
That's why.
Well, you're both very kind. It's just a privilege to be able to have this opportunity to share a few ideas with you. And as you know, if I can help you in any way, I am here for you.
Gotcha.
Thank you.
Well, thank you, Richard. And we'll have you back again.
Yes.
I'll look forward to it. Thank you so much. And mahalo.
All right. Thanks, Richard.
All right. You can reach Richard again at Richard, WEYLMAN.com, RichardWeylman.com. And he's a great resource, very kind person, a lot of
Much knowledge.
Yeah, so much knowledge
to tap into.
By the way, speaking of knowledge, what do we want to highlight? What do we want to share? You know, I'm going to share the
stats.
I got the surf report for real estate.
Oh my gosh, this most recent one was
holy moly, another record. For a median sale price for single family homes, still up. Let's see here. I don't have my glasses, but I can still read
my arms is 917,000 was what the median.
Well, price? And from a year ago, that's up 19%, almost 20%. 917,500 is the median sale price. You're like, Attilio, what's that mean? Half the homes sold above it, and half the homes sold below on Oahu. In February, closed sales 260, up about 6%. Days on market down 75%. From 28 or 6 days on the market down to 9.
Woo.
You go to the open house and you're like, oh, let me go home and think about it. Too late already.
It's gone.
So all you realtors, have your clients come listen to our show. We'll whack them around a little bit.
I'll give an example. We put one on the market. Put one on the market, and within 24 hours, we had three offers. And no showings, there's no showings till first open, but we had three offers in hand. I guess they felt comfortable with the videos and the Matterports. And
that's the key. Yeah. No matter how hot this market is, homes are still not selling themselves.
Mm-hmm.
Here's what I would tell you. One of the tips that I wanted to share with you guys is that it's very important. You know what? You don't need a realtor to sell your home.
What?
What? Yeah.
What?
That's it. We're changing. We're gonna open up a pawn shop. We're just hanging
it up.
Yeah.
We're done.
No. You know what you need? You don't need a realtor. You need an expert negotiator.
That's right. In this market, there's a different set of skills.
Yeah, and more so, Stu, if you're looking for a shortcut, I tell you, for sale by owner, that, you know what that means? That means I can come beat you up because I'm the expert negotiator, and I can tie up your property, not even be pre-approved because you're not even knowing to ask that type of question. So I would say, you know, still in that price, you know, with how much money people are spending and the amount of liability, they still are not selling themselves.
Well, it's like, I think it's one thing to get offers.
Yeah.
But it's a whole nother ballgame to go through that due diligence and that escrow process, because all sorts of things
come up,
can and will come up.
Yeah.
So just being able to navigate through those little landmines and through over 1,000 plus homes that we have been involved with. We've seen quite a bit of different things that have come up and been able to navigate through.
Well, one of the things we do have is a reputation of being tough negotiators. And that's a good thing, because when you have a Team Lally for sale sign in front of your home, it's almost like we put a lay of garlic around your neck for all the vampires that are circling that want to buy your home. And so we're protecting you. We're filtering out those inquiries, we're slowing everything down so that you can maximize. Nothing wrong with this. I know the buyers, you know, it is what it is, but you can maximize your sale price. And
sometimes, I would say sometimes it's not just the sale price, there's also the terms.
Yes.
And we've been able to get really creative to make some very attractive terms.
Yeah.
And outside of the box thinking.
Yeah. Some people are like, hey, I want to sell my home, but here's one that we hear people saying, and we're helping them with this. I want to sell my home, but I'm not ready to sell it now, but I don't want this hot market to pass me by.
Yeah.
So we have some strategies that allow you to, what is it? Sell now.
Buy later.
Buy later.
Mm-hmm.
So we got some strategies.
We've done it time and time again.
If you want to know more about that, just give us a call. 799-9596. What's that number again?
799-9596. Or you know what? Just Google us.
And we have three strategies that I don't know of anybody else that's utilizing to help buyers stop having your lunch handed to you in this market right now, because it's brutal.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we come in like an MMA warrior in a cage match. And, you know, when we get involved and represent you as a buyer, the other side wants to tap out, because we come in, we're bringing it. And we got resources. And again, if you want to know what those three things are that we do for our clients that I know other agents and real estate teams are not doing,
give us a call.
You know what? Just Google us, teamlally.com.
So we do have some open houses this weekend, teamlallyopenhouse.com, to get all the details. One of them is the Grand Open over in Coalina.
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful home.
Coalina Hillside.
That's right.
Where else?
So look for the signs. I would say go to the website to learn where else, but that is the grand.
Leave them wanting more. Good job. Here's one we're doing every day on Laie, Naupaka Street, Laie Point. We've got a nice home out there that you guys should stop by and take a look at it. We're sitting opens every day for the next 30 days. Go stop by and check it out.
All right. Well, thanks for listening, and thank you to our sponsors.
Jody Tanga and Derek Tanga of Pacific Rim Mortgage.
Bradley Mariam of Allstate Insurance.
Kenji Vendetta of Pillar to Post Home Inspections.
Janice Merland of Dreamhouse Drafting.
John Speed with Kilauea Pest Control.
Duke Kim Han of Hawaii Pacific Property Management.
Kyle Shimura, Impact Wealth Solutions.
Wendy Oshiro with Open Mortgage with Reverse Mortgages.
Robinson Villavier with Fine Line Paintworks.
And James Santiago of Kaji Cleaning.
If you want to get a hold of any of our sponsors, just go to teamlally.com.
We also want to give a big thank you to Leah Rodriguez, our producer here in the studio.
Yee-hoo!
Make sure to tune in next week. We'll have an awesome guest talking about something that'll change your life
forever. This is the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the guaranteed
sold program. If we can't sell your home at the agreed upon price and our time frame, we'll have it bought for cash.
Be safe and aloha.
The preceding program was sponsored by Team Lally.